La Za'Za Trattoria has been a staple in downtown St. Charles for 30 years now, specializing in northern Italian cuisine with prime and wagyu steaks and the freshest seafood.
Owner Dino Sisto joins us now to share one of his signature dishes, and this looks so good. Dino, thanks for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
I mean, you guys do everything from scratch.
Yes, pretty much, yeah.
And a lot of this are family recipes, right?
Yes, my mother was my inspiration. And unfortunately, she passed before we opened. Mm. And the rest was history. I mean, she's still with me every day.
Yeah.
So she's the guardian angel.
Mm. I love that. Okay, so yeah. What are you making for us today?
Well, we're gonna make the signature pasta dish that has been a staple for Za'Za's, number one pasta seller. It's got Italian sausage, pancetta.
Mm.
It's got shallots.
Let's get started.
Want to get
that?
Started?
Yeah, throw it in there.
All right, let's go. We're going to start this. It's going to be fast.
As you work it there. Is it? Well, that's always good.
Not in the
TV, right?
I don't
know how much smoke this is going to make, so I hope it doesn't.
Smoke us out. That's all right. We're good for it. Ooh. You're good for it. Oh, look at that.
The first thing you got to do is get this pancetta brown.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I noticed you didn't have any oil there in the pan.
It's got enough fat in there.
Okay.
So if you put too much oil, the dish will be really, really oily.
Mm. Yeah, it'll be a little slimy.
The pancetta will give off a lot of natural,
mm-hmm.
probably the better oils than some of the stuff they put on the market.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
But to move this along quickly, you want to brown the pancetta, get it to a nice color.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Then next, I throw in the onions and the garlic.
Ooh.
Mm. Get that in there a little bit.
I like the way you cook.
Yeah, put it all together.
Yeah.
Hey, and you brought us some wine too?
Oh, yes, yeah. Please.
Some Chianti?
We got a nice Chianti.
Ooh.
Some Tuscany. Mm. Salute, ladies.
Ooh, that's good. Did you grow up like by your mother's side as she was cooking?
I was hooked to her hip.
Yeah.
Out of my siblings, I was the one that was the biggest mama's boy.
Aww, I love
that
it.
That is very
My sweet. Aunt used to tell me, she, your mother could never put you down. You drove her crazy.
Are you the youngest?
I'm the middle boy.
Okay.
I have a sister that's the oldest, and I fall in the middle of my two brothers.
But you're the only one that went into the restaurant business, right?
Well, actually, my older brother did also.
Okay.
Yeah, so from this point, show a little white wine to kind of bring it down a little bit.
Okay.
This is so good. And you guys even make your own sausage, right?
Yes, we do. We've been making our own sausage since day one. The link sausage is stuffed with provolone and green peppers roasted inside it.
Yeah.
Mm. It's actually a recipe that has been very popular. From this point, we throw the sausage in.
Okay.
We're gonna have to move it along. I know there's not a ton of time.
That's all right, though.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
You gotta break this up in here.
Do you sell your sausage on the market?
No, we
don't.
No,
it's only in the restaurant.
Well, yeah.
You gotta come to you guys to get it, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I'll be honest with you, you know, it all starts with a quality purveyor,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Yeah.
And to be straight, we've been loyal to a purveyor that gives us 6 days of service, mm-hmm. which really no one does in this industry.
Mm.
Greco
so
and Sons.
So everything is fresh.
Yeah Greco
if it's
and
good
Sons.
Six days a week.
Got all the Italian import.
Well, obviously you're doing this right, because for a restaurant to be open as long as you've been open is pretty epic these days.
You know, truthfully, I've never really sat back and kind of looked at that, because it's a grind every day.
Yeah.
Mm. You know, so it's there's always something. My son's with me today, which is a huge plus.
Mm-hmm.
He's like the right hand. Actually, he is the restaurant. He runs the day-to-day operations.
Oh, nice.
Okay.
Family business.
It lets you stay in the kitchen and come up with these delicious recipes. Something you did during COVID, as you cooked this along, you came up with this, coffee cake?
It's actually a cream cheese coffee cake. It has a pecan crumble on top.
Ooh.
Homemade caramel. We normally serve it a la mode. Mm-hmm. A little warm.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man.
It's outstanding.
All right, I'm going to have to.
Oh, I knew you were going to sneak
I
on
mean,
down
come
there.
On.
Yeah,
sorry,
you gotta try. You can even try that first.
Okay, we're going to do a little reverse eating.
Yeah,
about that.
I like that.
You won't be disappointed.
No, not at all. Okay, so what else is on the menu? We know we got pastas.
Well, we're also known for our Lake Superior whitefish.
Mm. Ooh, that's
good. Pan roasted, finished in the oven. We serve it with baby capers.
Ooh, what up?
a lemon butter sauce that'll you could put on an old boot that would taste good.
Oh, man.
That's the actual.
This is to die for.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh.
Then you guys just did some renovations at the restaurant?
Well, we've done, but right now we're actually going to be doing a future rooftop. Probably a little over a year or so.
Okay.
We're going to put another food concept above Za'Za's.
Mm-hmm.
A rooftop that's going to be retractable overseeing the Fox River.
It's such a beautiful area there in St. Charles.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Yeah. How did you land in St. Charles? Is that where you're from?
No. I'm from the inner city, Taylor Street.
Yeah. Okay, would you feel like there were enough Italian restaurants in Taylor Street on Taylor
I
Street?
I think so.
No, okay.
Well, put it like the St. Charles was the best turn I ever took.
Oh, really?
But the funny part was getting my friends out there were like a challenge. They came once and they're like, "We love you, but it's a little too far." You know.
Well, clearly so many people are coming.
New friends out there.
But you know what? St. Charles has been very supportive. The Tri-Cities, the mayor, you know, has been doing a great job. It's really been a blessing.
That's great. You have your sauce already done too, right?
Yeah, I do.
I want to make sure we see it.
Yeah,
we're
I
want to
actually take this off.
Look at that.
Look at that.
This is the finished product.
What type of pasta do you use?
We use DiCecco. It's an imported pasta from Italy.
Okay.
It's a dry pasta, but it goes perfect with the sauce. I'm gonna wrap this up real quick.
Make sure it's cheesecake.
Holy cow, just
watch the sauce. You put the tomato sauce in.
Are you gonna use a penne? I think that's what we said was in the recipe. It's a penne pasta.
Penne?
Penne.
Yeah. I'm
sorry. Penne.
Hey,
listen, I've heard
delicious.
Worse. I've heard worse. Don't worry about it.
Well, yeah, I can only imagine.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, Dino. Everybody go check out La Za'Za Trattoria over there on First Street in St. Charles. You can see the social media handles as well as the website.